In this tutorial, we will be taking a look at the Replace Face feature. Let's start with a simple example to understand the basic concepts. So here is a cylinder with the top face in red. This is a face that needs to be replaced. I have a series of surface extrudes here at different levels. These will serve as the replacement faces. Go to Modify, Replace Face. The source face is the face that needs to be replaced, which will be the top of the cylinder, so select that. The target face is the face that will serve as the replacement. You can also think of this as the surface that you want to emulate. Let's select the face at the top. The resultant effect here is identical to performing an extrude up to an object. Let's delete this target face and select the third target face, which cuts into the body entirely. The overall effect here will be similar to using the surface to split the body and then deleting the upper body. Let's try using this surface which cuts across the top face of the cylinder. Looking from the side, a portion of the cylinder is below the surface, while the rest is above the surface. Let's see how this is resolved. The portion of the cylinder that was under the surface was extended up to the surface, while the portion of the cylinder above the surface was trimmed off. Let's try the bottom surface that is completely under the solid. An error message pops up. If the target face is below the source face, the target face has to completely or partially cut through the solid. Another rule is that the target face has to completely cover the source face. Let's take a look at the top view and edit the circle sketch such that it exceeds the edges of the target face. If we perform the replace face feature now, it will fail. If you experience this issue, you can activate the surface tab, go to Modify, Extend, and extend the surface as necessary. Take note also of the following rules. For source faces, you are only allowed to select faces of existing solid bodies. Surface bodies cannot be selected. For target faces, either faces of solids or surface bodies can be selected. Let's move on to a more practical example. A case where the replace face feature can prove really useful. We have an imported solid here with quite a complex top surface. A cylinder was extruded up to that surface and a series of cuts were made to create this fin-like structure. Suppose that there is now a change of plan and we need the top face of the fins to follow that of the original face. Let's roll back to the point to before the extruded cylinder was created. Activate the surface tab and go to Create Offset. Adjust the offset accordingly. In this case, the complexity of the surface does not result in a desirable surface. Let's keep the offset at 0 and try moving this face up using the Move Copy command. If I hide the body, you can see that the copied face is in the exact same position as the original face. Go to Modify, Move Copy. For Move Object, select Bodies and select the surface. For Move Type, select Translate. Move the surface body up accordingly. Roll the timeline forward to the point after the cylinder was created. Now, we are ready to replace the top face of the cylinder. Activate the Solid tab, go to Modify, Replace Face. Select the top of the cylinder as the source face, and select the offset face as the target. Let's hide the surface and roll the timeline forward.